Okay, yesterday we saw how to store some complex object in the database, combination of 3 to 4 tables. I think we are using totally 5 tables, right? 5 tables where you store that, the 5 tables having some relationship. Through that relationship we are stored. While storing customer object, all dependent object automatically gets stored through JPA, through JPA relationship. Now, there are some few issues we saw yesterday. The first one is, are you able to hear my voice, right? Hello?
Yes, sir, I can hear
you. Yes, we can hear you.
So we while saving this customer data, I am not able to store the user ID inside a customer address table, right? Through that, in the address table, I am not able to map the user ID. Because of this, we don't know which user having this particular address. That is the issue. We have to fix that. Then we are not able to store the role and the user underscore. That is the two things we saw, two issues that we can resolve today. Go to user service, the user service, the customer section, right? This part yesterday is uncommon. Okay, this is the fix for the two issues. The reason is the user ID is not stored, right? Because the user is coming from customer. Okay, now I want to set this user inside address object. So here is the simple fix I have given here. I am taking use customer dot get user from the customer. I'm taking get user. Then user is having some address. User is having address object. In this address object, I want to set this user ID. Then this issue get fixed. So the Hibernate expecting to manually set that user object inside a user of address. Address object. For example, I will explain you more clearly here. First, we have a customer object. First, I want to take a user. Yeah, we have already taken a user. User equal to customer.getUser. From the customer object, taking the getUser. Then list. What is this? Address. Address is equal to user dot get address. Now this address is having a this user object is having an address list of addresses. You can have more than one address. Okay, then in this address object we have a one user object. User equal to. Okay. Now what I'm doing is now address dot get. I'm taking a first address. It may contain one or two address, right? So I'm taking first address object from the list, then set. It has a one user object called, it has one user object, user. In that user object, we have to set whatever user populated here. Actually, we are populating the user under customer only, but here we are not populating, right? So I'm setting this user here. This user also, that's it. Once it's set like this, what will happen? This particular address 0, the 0th element, there is an address, right? That address object will have a ID properly. That is a fix for this particular issue. Okay. Then role. I want to generate the role also. Whenever create a user, I want to give some default role to the user. For that, I populated two roles in this application. When I go to the role table, in the role table I have a two roles. As of now there is no role here. We need to populate. I'll go to populate one role here. Customer role. This is customer role. This is the customer role. I am saying role name is a customer underscore role. Then another role is, this is employee role. I am saying here customer, sorry, employee underscore. Save it. Now in this table we have a two role. This is like a static data. We have to populate this particular table. So based on the company, right? Company should decide how many roles they should have. That role, they have to decide that role. That role we need to, they should populate the particular table. I am using the role table. In the role table, I am populating whatever role I need. I want to associate this role to particular user. Whenever I save any user, I want to associate this role to the particular user. Okay. Then this role ID is 1 and 2. Role ID is 1 and 2. Okay. In the code, the user service code, what I am doing here? Where is that? Oh, I changed some other class. Sorry. Yes. Okay. So according to this line, I have set the user ID to the address object. According to this particular code, I set the user ID to address object. Then from the role repository, I created a role repository here. Where it is role repository? Role repository. I created a role repository. Okay, from this role repository, I will going to take one role that I need. Role repository. Okay. Now, role repository defined by what? The one ID is a customer role. The database one ID is a customer role, right? So I am going to fetch that first role. Find by ID one of get. This will return a role object. This will return a role object. As per our mapping, one user can have a multiple role. That's the reason we are having a list. Inside a user object, we have a role list, right? We have a role list. Okay, we need to assign the role in the form of list object. In the form of list object, okay? So, in the user service, what I am saying is, I am retrieving the one role which I need for a customer. For a customer, I need a first role. First role is a customer role. So, I am fetching that role. Then, here I am constructing the list of roles equal to arrays dot as list. I am passing this particular role. This will create the roles list object. Then user dot set roles of I am passing these roles. Once you pass these roles, this particular role, whatever roles available inside this list, those role is associated with this particular user object. This user is coming from where? Customer object, right? So this customer having the particular role. Okay. Now finally, I am saying customer repository dot save of customer. When I say save, the customer will going to save the user object. Inside the user object, it will save the address object. In the address object, it will save the user ID because of this line. Then the user, I am setting the roles, right? That's the reason it will associate the particular role to that user. Now I'll going to run this application. Server started. Let me open the Postman. Now I want to save this customer, right? Post. What happened? Okay, I'll go to change customer profile to type to custom profile to, I'll go to change the data. Then two. Okay, now I'll go to send a request. Let me clear. Yeah, I got the response here. Let me see the response. 201 created. So here we have a address now. Let me see that address ID is associated or not. Then see role is coming. Role is ID 1, name customer roles. These customer whatever I have populated in the database, that role associated with this particular user. Okay, let's check the database now. There must be a new row. There is a second row. It's created. Is user ID is a 4. In the address that should create now. See here, the 4 is coming now. 4 is added. This 4 is user ID. The fourth user ID belongs to this address. Then role. In the role, I populated the two roles, right? One is a customer role. The customer role ID is a 1. User is a ID is a 4. These two, the fourth user ID associated with the second first role ID. That relation available in the user underscore role. That table created by automatically. That particular detail we mentioned in that POJO object, right? That entity object. When you look at your user table, user object, in that user object we have mentioned user underscore role. These are joint table of user and role, right? When you see here, user ID is a 4 associated with the role ID 1. This data also inserted. So there is a 4 insert statement: user, address, customer, and the user underscore role. So in a single call, we have populated the 4 different table using the relationship, JPA relationship. Okay. Now we're going to see various type of queries. How to perform a various type of queries through the JPA. Okay. Okay. Now let me go to customer repository. The customer repository, here we have two queries. See here, customer, find customer by customer type. These we have to follow some standards. Okay, for example, I want to find a customer by type. There is one column, right, in the database. Database, you can see customer, we have a customer type. I want to get the data based on this type. Okay, so for that, I need to define a method in JPA. We have to use find. Find is a mandatory. Then we have to use customer. Which object you want to perform query? Customer is for customer. Then by which column? By customer type. By customer type. Whatever object available here. Whatever attribute available here. That attribute just to copy and paste here. Customer type. That should be this standard we have to follow. Then parameter, we have to tell the parameter string customer type. This will generate select star from customer table where customer type equal to whatever value we are passing. That query it will generate, it will return the customer object. Okay. This customer type I am using in a user service class. Go to here. Let me copy that. Yeah, find by customer ID. Then this is my service class. The service class I am defining a one more method, find customer by type. The same method name which is available in the repository class. The same name I am giving. whatever name it's there, the same name I'm giving the user service. Then here inside the method, I'm returning customer repository dot find customer by customer type. Find customer by customer type. So when I'm passing this customer type to this repository method, to this repository method, this method coming from where? This method coming from controller class. In the controller class, we have to call this at get mapping customer. Not customers, customers slash types. That's it. Let me check that particular controller class. This is the thing I'm using. I'll just copy that. Okay, then copy this method also. Okay, these are my path to access this endpoint. Customers, customer type. We need to pass customer base slash. I am saying type. These are we can. This just I am saying this endpoint for retrieving the customer for by customer type. Okay. Then this customer type is a path variable, right? For this path variable, we have to pass some value here. At path variable, string customer type. Whatever customer type we are passing here, that customer type passing to user service. User service will call the repository object by passing the customer type. That will return a customer. That customer I am passing as a response object through response entity. Through response entity, I am passing as a response object. The first argument I am passing customer. Second argument I am passing success. That's it. Well, these are one type of query. Then go to the user service. We'll complete all type of queries today as much as possible. Then I want to pass multiple types of customer. In the single query, I want to pass multiple values. In the single query, I want to pass multiple values in the var classes. So for that, I am constructing one more query method. Find customer by customer type in. Customer type in. In means we can pass multiple values. That's the reason you are passing a list object. This list object can contain multiple types. Type 1, type 2, type 3, like that. Multiple object we can pass. Now this will generate like this query. This will generate select start from customer where customer customer underscore type in type 1, type 2, like that. This JPA query method generate like this query, then return a multiple customer, then return a multiple customer. Okay. Then this is this two method, right? Two method by following some standards, I am constructing the JPA query. Okay, we need to follow some standards, the naming convention. We have to use find, then we have to tell that customer object, then we have to say by. After by, we have to tell which column. Okay, through that standards, I am constructing a JPA query method. This query method return a based on this definition, this return a query. Here I am passing query. I am creating a query on the Java object, on the Java object JPA query. Okay, here I am saying query. We have to use one parameter called add query. Instead of add query, we need to write the query on the object, customer object. We need to pass the query on the customer object. Here what I am saying, select C from customer. From which object you want to generate the query? I want to generate the query from the customer object. So select C from customer followed by alias name. It's kind of variable name. For customer, I am saying variable is a C. Generally, they will call it as an alias name. Okay. So this particular variable name we have to use here. Select C, whatever variable we will going to use here, that variable we have to use here. Select C meaning that meaning of this particular thing is you are selecting all the columns. You are selecting all the columns from the customer table. Select C from customer.c where C dot customer type. Whatever column attribute available in the customer type. Sorry, in the customer object. C dot customer type in. I am using in operator. colon followed by some parameter variable, followed by some parameter variable. This is called as a parameter, query parameter variable. I want here these act as a query parameter variable. Okay, these act as a query parameter variable. If you construct your Hibernate query, this is a Hibernate query, right? Hibernate query meaning you are constructing the query using Java object. Now when you construct the query, we need to pass some var classes dynamically. We need to pass some value in the var classes dynamically. That time we need to pass some parameters. Parameters variable name start from colon. Start from colon. Var c dot customer type in. In meaning we can in that value. If you pass in, we can pass multiple values in the var class. In colon customer type, I'm saying. That is in the customer is a parameter type. This parameter variable name we have to place in our method name. Now for this query, we need to create our own method. Here you followed some standards, right? But in this case, we don't have to follow any standards. You can use your own name. So use add query annotation. I have given one query. Then now I want to capture that query result. For that, I am defining the one method here. Find customer by customer type. Query. This is my own name only. To understanding purpose, I pass this query because I am constructing the manually here query, right? That's the reason I given the name as a type query. Find customer by customer type query. Here in this var class, I am passing one parameter, right? One parameter. So if you pass one parameter, we need to give some value to the parameter. For that, I am using add param. What is the parameter name? Customer type. That customer type we have to pass here. Then this customer here I am passing in. In meaning we can pass multiple values. That meaning the parameter type must be the list object. List, that is a string value. Inside a list we have to maintain string value. List of string, then customer type. Okay. Whenever call this query, what will happen? It will accept this parameter. Based on this query, it will generate the native query. What is a native query? I am using MySQL. Whatever query we need to generate for MySQL, the JPI will generate the query for MySQL. Okay, that is called as native query. Based on this query, it will generate the native query. Select star from the same query it will generate. Whatever I have given here, right? The same query it will generate. Okay, here I am not using a query through some method, the JPI query method. I am constructing this query. Here manually I am generating a query, defining query on the customer object. Okay, we'll see these two examples now. Okay, service method. Okay, now for that service method, I created a endpoint customer type in. This is using JPA methods. Using JPA query method. Here I am calling JPA query method. Here I am calling the query which I created manually. Okay, for this endpoint. Yeah, service started. Then we have to say customer type. In customer type in query, two method we need to verify. two or three method. I think we need to test three method, right? This also. These three we need to test. These three. First, we will go with customer type. Slash. What is the endpoint? Type slash type. The database, you have a customer type 1. I want to fetch this type 1. Okay, customer type 1 and type method is a get method. See, I got that data. Only I got the customer type 1. Now I'm going to change the type 2. Now I got the customer type 2. Okay, through this method, through this method. Okay, now I want to use in operator using JPA method. Okay, for this type slash in, right? Type type slash in, then here I am passing query param, request param of cust type. Cust type, what is the cust type? We have to pass multiple value, right? Cust type question mark, cust type, you are already there. I am passing type 2, type 3. We have only type 1, type 2, right? So I am going to see here type 2 and type 1. Send. See, here we have type 1, also we got the type 2. Now I am going to remove the type 1. Now I am getting only type 2. Only I type 2, I got that. Got the query. Then third one is the same functionality. I am passing the manual query. Right? I written a query. This query generated by Hibernate. That is JPA. This query generated by ourselves. The program I have written select C customer from customer object. Like that I generate manually. I use the query using add query annotation. Let me check that. In slash query. In slash query. Then we have to pass the same query parameter. Send. So I got the output here. Then I am going to pass 1. I got the output here. Okay. So now we have tested three different queries through the JPA. What is next? You will see that. Okay, this I'll come back to later. Okay. Then go to user object. User. Okay. Let me check what is the data in the user table. The user, we have two data, right? Suresh and the customer 1, Suresh and the customer 2. Okay. Now I want to customer type. In the user service, I'll copy this. Go to user service, user repository, I paste it here. List user, find user by email ID. I want to find the data from the user table. So I'm using find user by which column? Email ID. By which column? Email ID. Then which operator I want to use? I want to use like operator. I want to use like operator. Okay. In the like operator, I can pass some string value within a percentage, right? Within a percentage, we need to pass some string value. Based on that string value, that like operator return the data. Okay. For example, let's say, So let's start from user where email ID like percentage customer 2%. I'm giving here, this is the query. This based on this condition, this is giving the only second record, because customer, in the email ID value, the customer's data having with customer 2, the email having a customer 2, email data having a customer 2, I want to return that particular query. So it's returning the particular row only. I want to perform this kind of query in a JPA. For that, here I am using find user. Find is the we have to use. Then which object you want to perform a query on the user object. By which column I want to use the email ID column. Which operator I want to use a like operator. I want to use like operator. Then like expression we have to say in the form of string value. In the form of string value. Okay. Then the user service, I'm going to copy this method. Then declare, here I have not declared user repository, so I'm declaring user repository. Private user repository, user repository. Okay. Why it's giving error here? Okay, let me check user repository, then user controller. Then user controller, we need to copy this method. Okay, in the controller class, I'm creating one endpoint called like. This will, we have to use API slash user slash like. Slash like this endpoint we need to use. When you call this endpoint, what I'm doing here, get all user like at request param, I need to pass any string in the email. In the email, then I'm calling user service dot find user by email ID. From the service class, I'm calling this service method. While passing the service the particular method, I am passing percentage and percentage. Percentage and percentage. In between, I am passing this particular email string. In the query, I am doing the same, right? Here, our responsibility to pass the percentage. Percentage, then whatever string you want, I am passing here. Then, it will go ahead, it will call this particular method. It will call this particular method. The percentage, the string value, that string value, then percentage will go here. According to the parameter, according to this method, that will return like this query. That will return like this native query for your MySQL. Okay. Then the same operation I am doing here also. No difference. Only way of doing is different, but the result is same. At query select user object. That is user U. I am giving alias name U, right? Select U from user U where U dot email ID. u.email id like it's a like operator. Then here itself I am passing percentage, then inside, then here percentage, in within percentage I am passing the parameter. Always start with colon, right? Colon email id I am passing here. So this method then can be anything now, because I am using my own query. Find user by email id like query. Then here we are passing one parameter, right? So we have to create a one parameter name for that using at param annotation. At param, I am passing this parameter name. For the parameter, we need to pass the value here. Whatever value coming here, that value substituted here. Substitute here, then this query execute and give the list of user. Okay. Okay, let me start the application, test that. Are you clear, right? Are you able to follow me? Okay. Now I'm going to check this particular endpoint. This is using a JPA methods to fetch the particular data based on the email string. It's a user slash like. Now I'll going to pass query parameter. This customer too. Okay. Customer I'm going to pass. Bad request. Okay. Customer. Oh, sorry. I'm not passing the query parameter name. So we have to say email, right? Email equal to customer. So I'm getting a customer 2 here. Now if you pass customer 1, so customer 1 only, right? Customer 1, yeah. I am getting customer 1 now. If you pass only customer, it will return both. Customer 1 as well as customer. It returning both the value. Okay. This is the purpose of like operator. Also, you know how to use the like operator in a JPA level. Okay. This query is, I am preparing my query, one query. And using like operator. Through this method, the Hibernate generating, JPA is generating based on my method definition. Here I am using my one query, using like operator. Okay. When you look at here I am passing percentage, but here I am not passing percentage because in the JPA, repository itself, I am passing this percentage. Within percentage, I am passing a parameter. Okay. Now query. Email equal to customer. Same output will come. Okay, customer. I will going to say customer 2. Customer 2 is coming. Now I am going to use customer 1. Customer 1 is coming. Okay, the customer 1 does not have address in roles. That's the reason giving empty. Okay. Okay, now going to see what is next in the user repository. Okay. Then customer, going back to the customer repository. In some cases, right, we need to fetch particular column from the table, particular column from the table. Okay, we need to fetch a particular column from the table. In such a case, we need to specify that particular attribute from your object, from your Java object. Okay, from your Java object. Let me comment out this particular program now. I'm going to create a new one. Then select new, I don't want this and all. Then I'm going to Now here at query, I am saying select c.id, c.customer profile, c.customer type. In the customer profile object, the customer, sorry, in the customer object, where is customer object? I want to fetch only these three column. That meaning the from the customer table, I want to fetch only these three column. I don't want to fetch user related information. I need only these three information. For that, in the customer repository, what I am doing here? Select c.id, c.customer profile, c.customer type. From customer, c where c.id equal to customer id. So in this JPA query, I am mentioning only three column. From customer, and it's alias type, right? From this alias name, I'm referring c.id, c.customer profile, c.customer type from the customer object, from the customer object. Then what basis you want to return this data? What basis? Where c.id, whatever customer ID I'm providing here, that corresponding customer ID, please return that corresponding customer ID. Then here I'm saying object array. Object array, find customer profile. This is my customer, this method name, this can be anything because I'm using my one query. This can be anything. Find customer profile. At param, I'm passing this customer ID as a parameter. Then this customer ID is an integer. So I'm saying it's an int profile ID. Here one confusion is why I'm using object of array. You may get some question, right? Object array, because I am selecting particular column alone here. So the Hibernate don't know, JPA don't know what is the which an entity we need to use to populate that. That is not that much intelligent. So selecting only three attribute, it's give the object array. Give the object array. So it's give the object array, right? Let's check that. Now what you have to do from here? We need to take this for zeroth position. That is object of zeroth position, ID will be available, one position, customer profile available, and then second position, customer type will be available. Customer type will be available. But this type kind of complex, right? We need to once return that, we need to say object 0.1, object 1 of 1, object 2 of 1, like that we have to say. To avoid this complexity, we can use some another approach. You can use some another approach. Let me create a one table, sorry, one object here. Customer info, new class customer info. New class customer info. Then I'll going to take these three attribute. We don't need this mapping and all. Then create one constructor, public customer info, will create by IntelliJ, don't want to waste time, generate getter setter first, then generate a customer, a constructor, customer info constructor with this all parameter, customer is, now I created a one object, customer info object, the customer info object having a only three attributes. Okay, I want to populate this attribute by using that query. Okay, now go to the customer repository class. I'll comment out this. I'll uncomment. Here, select new. I'm saying new. I'm initializing an object. Select new com.itgarden.account. Where is this package? Customer info coming from where? Info coming from com.itgarden user service, right? Just take this package path. Select a new. Just give that package path here. Then dot customer info. In the package, I want to use one class called customer info. That customer info having a one constructor, it accepting three parameter. One, first parameter is a integer type, which is a customer ID. Second parameter is a string type, which is a customer type. Third parameter is a customer profile, which is a again string type. We need to pass these three parameter, right? In the customer repository class, what I am doing? New customer. The first parameter is the customer profile ID. I am passing C dot ID from customer object. From this customer object, I am saying C dot ID, C dot customer type. Second parameter is the customer type, right? So second parameter customer type. Third parameter is a C dot customer profile. Now I am whatever query coming from the whatever query I am using here, that query column I am passing in this constructor. In this constructor, though through that query some value get populated here, that value automatically get populated in customer info object. Okay, so whenever fire this query, what will happen? For this customer ID, one data will come database. That data will be passed in this constructor of customer info. Now that value is available in the customer info. So whenever call this method, this will return a customer info. Through this way, I can fetch particular column from the particular table. Okay. If you fetch all the column, no problem. You can take this entity object. If you want to select a particular column, we have to go like this. You don't have to use this. It's not a mandatory. If you're not using this column, return the form of object array. That is the problem. Okay. From the object array, we need to take that one by one. But this is easy, right? We are mapping it. Whatever column we are fetching from this table, that column value are mapping into customer info. Mapping into customer info. Okay. Now go to account service. Here, what is the value? Okay, let's check this now. In this endpoint is a customer's profile slash customer ID. I'm passing then customer ID as into path variable. Then I'm calling user service dot find customer profile from the service class. In the service class, I'm calling a find customer profile from the customer repository. Here I am defining a query. Through this query, I'm saying I want to fetch only particular column. That column value is populated in customer info. This customer info finally returned into your customer controller as the response. See responsibility customer info I'm passing it. Okay. Postman customer profile user slash customer profile then customer ID. We have a customer ID 1 here. Yeah, we have customer ID 1 and 2 with both. So I'm getting only three attributes: ID, customer type, and the customer profile one. Now I'm going to set two. So through this way we can fetch particular attributes from the customer table, from the table. Okay, then. How to use a native query? How to use a native query? Say I want to use a native query. That is this query. This is a raw query. This is a native query, right? Select star from user. Select star from user. This is a MySQL query, native query. The same query I want to use in a JPA. That is also possible. In case at query annotation, we need to pass two attributes. The first two parameter, the first parameter is a value. Value equal to, we have to pass the native query. You have to pass the native query. Here I'm saying select star from customer var id equal to parameter. If you're going to use a native query, we need to pass parameter. We need to pass parameter as a question mark. Here we have passed parameter as a colon, right? If you're using native query, we have to pass parameter called a question mark. Here I'm saying one. Parameter. If you have a multiple parameter, we have to say parameter question mark 1, question mark 2, question mark 3, like that we have to go. Since here using only one parameter, I am not using a 1, 2 and all, just I am using question mark. Or you can mention parameter number. This is the first parameter. Find the customer profile native, customer profile native method is a customer profile native, then param of id. Param of id equal to int id. Okay, I'm passing a int id. Okay, then we have to say this query is a native query. This query is a native query. Native query equal to true. You have to say native query equal to true, meaning you can pass some raw SQL. That is a native SQL you can pass here. Okay, let's see if it's coming or not. So I will not define the method. In the service class, I am calling that native query method. This query always return object type, okay? Because we are using object native query, right? JPA cannot map this data to the respective entity object because we are using a native query. So this always return object type. Always return an object array. This object array will contain some columns. For example, here we have a four columns, right? That four column will be available in the object array. Okay. Okay. What is the endpoint? Endpoint is a customer profile native. Profile native slash two. So it's returning all the data in the form of array. See, it's brackets coming. Bracket is coming, right? So it's giving us an array of the object array. Okay, here you don't see that customer name, the customer profile, customer type, ID, user ID. Those attributes you're not able to see, right? But when you're using that JPA query, it's mapping to the corresponding entity object. That entity object attribute was showing here customer name equal to customer name, ID equal to ID, like something like that. We saw the response, but here we are seeing only the value. That meaning it's returning an object array. Okay, when using native query, it will return an object array only. Okay, guys. The Spring. Any other question from anyone?
Nothing for now. If anything, I'll get back to you.
Okay. Next, we need to start microservices. Okay. We have covered as much as possible in the Spring Boot. Whatever concept you have, so many things I think we have covered. Okay, and next we have to start with the microservices. How to create a microservice environment? See, microservice nothing but each application is Spring Boot only. We have a 10 microservices. Each application is Spring Boot only. Okay, we have to collaborate those Spring Boot application in proper way. For that, Spring Boot provide one framework called Spring Cloud Component. Spring Cloud Component. You need to learn what is the purpose of Spring Cloud Component. How to use that Spring Cloud Component inside a Spring Boot application to make microservice environment. Then what is advantage of that? Those things we'll going to see. Okay. We'll start tomorrow that, not today. Still not subscribe this channel, please subscribe it, share this video to your friend circle, click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video.